Okay, so this is the product we have is Approtech Porous Pipe. We started manufacturing the pipe in 1998. And as of today's date, we have achieved a patent from Government of India for this product. It is an eco-friendly product. When I say eco-friendly, it's made of recycled rubber, recycled plastic polymers. The manufacturing plant is in Gujarat, in Baroda. The durability of this product, as we say, is more than 25 years. And we have got it tested from a professor in Ohio State University in America. It's a subsurface irrigation system, which goes around 8 to 12 inches below the surface. Works on a low flow, low pressure system. So the operating pressure is only 0.3 kg. So if you have an overhead tank at 10 feet, 15 feet maximum, you can irrigate up to 100 acres of land together. The only reason why we recommend farmers for having an overhead tank is to save energy and save water. Energy is saved because throwing water from the borewell to the field consumes more energy than throwing water from the borewell to the overhead tank. If you have an auto guard, it will basically solve a lot of problems in human like, let's say you have a labor problem, you don't want that. You stay 100 kilometers away from your farm, you just have an auto guard. Whenever the electricity is there, it's automatically going to fill and stop. Now the pipe functions as, it's just going to deliver moisture to the root zone. We don't want too much water at the root zone. Too much water is as well harmful for the plant. So what happens is the root zone is going to absorb moisture from the soil. The soil is going to absorb moisture from the pipe. Once there's an equilibrium between the plant and the soil, the discharge will automatically go down. The normal discharge of the pipe at 0.3 kg pressure at yellow soil is 1.9 liters per meter per hour. And if you increase the pressure, the discharge is automatically going to go up, which is not harmful, but that is not something that we want. We just want moisture. We don't want too much water in the soil. And when there's an equilibrium, we have studied that the discharge goes up to 0.3 liters per meter per hour. That is perfectly fine. Now, how the system operates is when we lay the pipe, it is laid automatically. It's laid by a machine. There's no human power needed to lay the pipes. There's a subunit that goes behind a tractor. It trenches, it lays, and it even fills up the soil on the top of it. So whatever depth you want, 8 inches or 12 inches, it will go at that depth. Now, once it's laid, we recommend running the system for at least 24 hours non-stop. At that time, the farmer does think that there's a lot of waste of water, but it is actually not a waste of water. It is saving of water for tomorrow. Now, why we do this is because if your waterbed is, let's say, 50 feet below the ground, you need to first get the waterbed up. Only then you can see the saving in water. Once the waterbed is up, then the water discharge will be low automatically. You don't need a lot of water in that. So that is why we recommend the farmers to use the system for 24 hours. And then on the other day, once the plantation is done, depending on the crop, we advise the farmers to run the system. Normally, we only advise the farmers to use the system for 4 hours per day, per acre, not more than that. If you have a bigger water tank, let's say you have 50,000 liters of water, you can irrigate up to 20 hectares at a time. We have a farmer in Gujarat who has 50,000 liters of water at around 15 feet, and he is using that much water to irrigate 28 hectares altogether. He is not using any valves, no block system, nothing. He is just using one valve and he gives it water to the entire field. Now, the reason why we still do blocks. We do still have plot system like the drip irrigation, but that is not to use it every day. That is when you are in deficit of water. When you don't have enough water, like let's say you have water for 12 acres or 15 acres, but you have a land holding of 25 acres. We don't want that much water to go into 25 acres at a time. And as you guys are into organic farming, and I told you why mulching shear and why not fodder. So you said there's a lot of weeding problem. This product will actually save a lot of money when you say weeding. Now we have farmers in Nasik who are doing pomegranate, who who has 2.5 acres of pomegranate in drip and 2.5 acres in porous pipe. Both of them are 2 years old, and the difference between the two, when you say growth, the crop which is planted with porous pipe is 7 feet tall right now with 80 fruits per plant. Whereas the same case when you go for the drip, the plant is only 4.5 feet with zero fruiting. And he has spent around 24,000 rupees per year last year for weeding in drip, whereas he's only spent 5,000 rupees per acre for porous pipe. So there is a huge difference because the seeds are not going to be in direct contact to the moisture. The moisture is going to be at the root zone. So there's very less chances of weeds. Yes, there will be weeds after monsoon, not before that. Now, the farmer in Gujarat, they only use basically fodder. They don't use mulching. There are two reasons for that. One is they have worm activity going on there. So they throw worms there every year. So there's better aeration of the soil. And the second reason why they don't use mulch is because it raises the soil temperature. When it raises the soil temperature, there are a lot of chances that the root zone might get burnt. So then again, your productivity will be less. Spending too much, and even mulching sheet is a bit more expensive than the fodder as well. Fodder, you get it around, when in Gujarat, they buy it per truck. They buy around 1,000 rupees per truck, that's it. That is good for around 1 acre or 2 acres. The other benefit that I would say in this pipe is, once it's laid, it's a permanent solution. You don't need to take it out again at the time of harvesting. In the case of drip, when you pull the pipes during harvesting, there are cracks, there are leakages, there are breaks. Yes, there's rat bites. This pipe is not a problem. You can use these pipes even if you have rats, termites, insects. High TDS water is not an issue with this pipe as well. You can use up to 4500 TDS water without doing acid treatment for. Whereas in drip, you do have a lot of TDS problems. The pipes, the emitters do get choked up. In long run, you have to have a HCl treatment, sulfuric acid treatment done at least once a year. And the other benefits are again labor. Less chances of this pipe getting, you know, chori nahi ho sakti hai pipe aapki. Because the cost to dig for this pipe is more than the cost of the pipe. Whereas the drip is on the surface, so anyone can take it out. And dogs can also take it away with them. This pipe is not an issue like that. Yes. And again, plowing. A lot of farmers ask me, this pipe is going to be 10 inches, 8 inches, 12 inches. What if we plow the soil? So my question is, why plow the soil? Why do you need to plow it? Why do you need to cultivate the soil? The only answer I know, and when I've spoken to farmers, they said we need to soften the soil. Now, when you need to soften the soil, it's because there's salt on the soil. If there's salt deposition on the soil, you need to plow the soil. Whereas in this case, there's not going to be any salt deposition on the soil, because the moisture is directly at the root zone. So you don't need to plow. Yes, you can still cultivate the soil. The cultivator is not going to be more than 4 or 5 inches. Your pipe is going to be minimum 8 inches. So that's not a problem. Again, one more benefit of this pipe is there is no algae formation. In drippers, when you see the dripper at a plant, you see an algae formation during the summer. There is no algae formation when you use this pipe. So there are a lot of advantages, but I don't see any disadvantage. Yes, might be a cost. Our cost is around 15% more than the drip, but we do have a better durability of the product. Drip says 10 years, but I have not seen any farmer using a drip pipe for 10 years. The maximum they can use is 6 years. And the reason why they can only use for 6 years is because of the TDS. Once they do a sulfuric acid treatment, the wall thickness of the pipe goes low. There's a reaction with the pipe. Second is during harvesting, they pull off the pipes. When they pull off the pipe and during monsoon, they just throw the pipe at a corner. So there's nothing going on there. It is exposed directly to sunlight. So plastic reaction to the sunlight is plus. The pipe gets very soft when it's exposed to the sunlight. Whereas this pipe is buried under the ground, once and for all, there's no problem. So I think cost is a factor to the farmers for today's date, because obviously he has to look at the economy as well. But when I say 25 years, I don't think that should be a problem. And the life as well as, we're not even talking about money now. We're talking about saving. You need to look at the long-term saving that the farmer is going to have. Water saving, energy saving, manpower, even fertilizer saving. Not against drip, but against flood. There's around 70% saving of fertilizer over flood. And you can also use the same fertilizers that you've been using for drip. You can use organic fertilizer that are water soluble. You do get water soluble fertilizers, so you can just put it with this. There's no problem. See, basically, when we put the pipe at 8 inches, if it's a vegetable crop, we do not recommend more than 8 inches. And when we put it at 8 inches, the moisture is going to travel four ways. It is not just going to travel this down ways. It is going to travel vertically and horizontally upwards. So that should not be a problem. Plus, when we talk about the root zone, there are two types of root in a plant. One is the tap root, which is going to be the grip of the plant. And the other is capillary, which is going to be the water suppliers. So they are going to anyways go for the water. They'll look for water. Tap root will not always look for water. Capillary roots will always look for water. So if you put it at 8 inches, that should be good enough for vegetable crops. This can be used for paddy, for wheat. We have used it. For paddy, we have used it in Gujarat. We have used it for sugarcane in huge numbers in Maharashtra and in Gujarat. For cotton, coconut trees, mangoes, chiku, and all vegetable crops. We've used it for potatoes, eggplant, capsicum, chilies, then methi, which is again a densely cultivated crop. We still use it for methi as well, and chana. So I don't think it should be a problem even if the root zone is not more than 4 or 5 inches. It can be still laid at 8 inches and there should be sufficient moisture to the plant. For vegetables, we recommend 3 feet row-to-row spacing. So there's moisture overlap. So there's better productivity in that. For sugarcane, in Gujarat it's 5 feet, but in Maharashtra and in Karnataka it's 7 feet. Goes up to 7 to 8 feet. Pomegranate again is 8 feet to 10 feet, but in pomegranate and papaya, we recommend 2 lines per crop. It has to be 1 feet both ways for a better water availability of the crop. Same way for grapes, we need recommend 2 lines per crop. And even for sugarcane, a lot of our farmers have put it at 3 feet. Basically, we have 2 sizes of the pipe, 16mm and 22mm. I'm sorry, I'm late for that. 22mm is for the high water intake plants, which is sugarcane, coconut, mangoes, chiku. 16mm is for more of for horticultural crops. So your vegetables will be 16mm. As of right now, Karnataka government, we don't have subsidy for Karnataka state. So our MRP for 22mm is 25 rupees, and for 16mm per meter. And for 16mm, it's 19 rupees per meter. For both the pipes, company as a company, we give a 25% subsidy to the farmers. So 22mm would come around 18 rupees 75 paise per meter. And 16mm would come 14 rupees and 25 rupees paise per meter. So if it's 3 feet, the cost would be around not more than 60,000 rupees for the porous pipe. And even if you already have a drip system installed, so I'm sure you have the PVC channels going on. Yeah. We can use the same PVC channel for the porous pipe. We might just add one more PVC line at the end, because drip has a system that it would put an end cap after 150 feet. In our system, we connect the pipes, the porous pipe, at every 50 meters. So there's water flow from both the sides. So there's a looping. Because it's a continuous emission, we need to do that. Dripper has a dripper at every 1 feet, 2 feet. So they can go out till 150 feet. Plus, they use pressure. They require minimum 3 kg pressure. Whereas we don't require that much pressure. So we have to have two PVC pipe at every 50 meters. There are basically two ways to install the pipe. For agriculture, when you say vegetable crops, we do a lateral installation, which is straight. When you are talking about trees, like coconut trees, mango trees, we do a spiral installation. A lot of farmers we have seen, they use dripper for coconut. But I don't see a point using dripper for coconut. The root zone goes at around the, is not less than 20 feet diameter. This is a canopy, right? So its root zone has to be till here, right? It is there. Maybe this is bent, that is why you can say it's still here, but it has to be at least 10 feet radius, the canopy. Now when there's a dripper right there, how the moisture is going to travel till 10 feet, all four sides. So what we do is, we do a spiral looking at the canopy. So that is the plus point you can have, but otherwise what you have to do in coconut and mangoes is you have to make the waterbed. You have to fill the water once in a week. But that is again destroying the root zone. So this is one more benefit you can add to the porous pipe installations. See, as far as maintenance is concerned, there is only maintenance due to human error, not due to the product default. If there is a product default, the company itself wouldn't send it to you, because we get every role checked by our R&D departments. We get a certification done for every role. So if there's a cut, let's say there's a cut by a human or there's a cut by a machinery, there's always the joiner, which is used in drip. The accessories are all the same. The elbow, joiner, T, end caps, everything is same. So all you have to do is just join it. Now the other question would be, how would you come to know if there's a leakage there? You will actually see a lot of water coming out of the soil. You'll see bubbles coming out. That is when you'll come to know that there's a leakage here. When you have 100 trees, or maybe let's say 10 trees in a line, when you walk through the trees, if you see too much of water around one tree, you just have to make sure that there's a leakage. You just dig into it and you will find a leakage there. You just cut it properly and you put a joiner there. That's it. And screen filter is one thing that is mandatory. Filter is mandatory for our system, because unlike drip, we cannot flush our systems. We can do it, but it's a huge headache to flush this system. So what we recommend is, depending on the impurity in your water, we recommend putting a screen filter or a sand filter at the head unit, right at the source of water. So you always get clean water. Even if you get some sand particles or soil particles, it's not going to choke the pipe right away. It will take up to 7 years to choke the pipe. Because usme aisa hai ki wo kehte hai na ki machhar aaj kaatega, par malaria mahine ke baad hi hota hai. So that is the process time for this, because we have gone through one of our clients' problem. He has around 180 acres of land where he is using porous pipe. He had installed the pipe by himself, but he never put a filter there. After 8 years, he called me and he said there is no water coming out of the pipe. There were distances where you can see water. I was like, okay, let me see. We opened the pipe, he had put an end cap at every pipe. So there were impurities coming in the water. So I told him, is there a filter here? He said, no. And I said, that is the problem. You need to have a filter. He's like, what to do now? I'm like, you need to take off all the pipes and reinstall everything. And he actually did that. He took off all the pipes, bought new pipes and put it in. He said, but I've been using this system for 8 years now. I'm like, it doesn't happen overnight. It's a huge area, there's a lot of pipe here, so it does take a lot of time for you to clog the system. Yes, there are millions of pores. A lot of people ask us, how many pores do you have? I'm like, you cannot count them. It's a whole machinery thing that happens, because we basically play with the temperature. That is how we get pores. I can even reduce the pores, I can even increase the pores. That is all on us. See, when we make the pipe, the CPET, there's a company called CPET, which is the quality control company in Gujarat. They give every manufacturer who makes a pipe, they give every manufacturer up to 5% variation in the product. That is allowed, because see, the thing is, it is not something that is made handmade. It is done by a machinery and we play with temperatures. So if there's a slight variation in the temperature, there's a variation in the pipe. So up to 5% is allowed for us. We cannot go more than that. So that is why I said each and every roll that we manufacture goes to that company for quality testing. If they don't approve, we have to throw it in the scrap. If they approve, they give us a certification for that. Then this is the perfect one. And even when I'll show you the demo, you'll see the uniform discharge of water. It won't be that yahan pe nikal jayega, wahan nahi niklega.
That is the critical.
See, the functionality of the pipe is when the water is throughout the surface, the inner surface, that is when the water will come out. Water has to be in contact throughout the surface. Only then it will come out. Nahi to sirf niche hoga to bhi nahi niklega. Discharge can be measured using a water meter. See, what we can do is at a field per meter for 16 mm it's 1.9 liters per meter per hour,
okay.
And for 22 mm it goes up to 2.5 liters per meter per hour. And even you can calculate the quantity of water used in your field. You just have to put a water meter and it will give you how much water you're using. And that much quantity, if you divide it by the meter of pipe you're using, you'll get the discharge as well.
Okay.